Give me one back that my monitor turned off.
Hello? Hello?
Are you there?
Your monitor turned off right then?
Yes, that would have been.
At least it was just a monitor, not your PC.
Yeah, okay.
Meteor's having all kinds of difficulties.
Nobody panic, chat. I know that there's a black screen on Roll20 right now.
Yes, we're good.
Nobody panic.
We all see it.
Don't panic. So, hello everyone, and welcome to this 22nd session of In the Demon's Grasp with me, your host and DM, Firedale 2002. And today we have everyone with us. So, yay!
Hello! Full party!
Hey, you forgot the most important part of today, though.
Party!
It's Friday the 13th.
It's our Friday the 13th stream!
Let's try it to TPK. Yeah.
What happened to my monitor?
I mean, I'm totally ready for this ghost campaign.
Meteor's having technical difficulties.
Meteor's monitor is early for the TPK.
Monitor with all my stream stuff on it
just
went black. So I can't. There's no live button.
It for real said, oh, no. I don't want to do this no more. I don't want to work today, Dad.
You have shared screen, Meteor? Is it extended screen, or do you have to set up a separate monitors, separate desktops?
Extended screen.
Huh? Is your monitor to the right or to the left?
My main one is to the left.
The one that turned off.
Secondary. The one that turned off is to the right.
You can hold Alt, press space, then M, and then hold your right arrow key. Left arrow key, because it's to the right.
And then I'll move to the other monitor.
Yeah, that'll activate the move command for the window, and then whatever window you had selected will move to the left.
What?
Hold Alt, press space, press M, after letting go of Alt and space, and then push your left arrow.
Ooh, it's working! My entire right monitor is just off now for some reason, but...
So did that at least get the stuff where you can see it? Yay, yes. Meteor's live. Glad to help. Can you tell I've dealt with this before?
Yes.
Allie said, Zabala Ginga Post. Oh wait, stop talking backwards. Sorry, I read it backwards.
I told you to stop talking backwards.
That wasn't Allie, that was
the mirrors
Meteor.
Do a thing. So, hello. Well, I did it too. Banana didn't read my chat. So, again, now that everyone's actually here, welcome to the 22nd session of In the Demon's Grasp. Sorry, we had Meteor had a few technical difficulties there. So, when last we left off, the party had just awoken from a nice fitful rest, or fitless rest. Why is soundless bad for sleeping? Anyways,
they
just woke up.
I sleep with earplugs. I prefer soundless, thank you.
Princess saw a humongous boulder flying at their recently grown pumpkin hut and alerted everybody. And everyone managed to jump out the windows, get teleported. Midnight jumped into a ring, and Kalina got that outside. So everybody is out. The thing waylaid the pumpkin hut, and it was destroyed. And so we will start with everybody rolling initiative, if you would.
Do we get to see the map?
Yeah, how can we... No, we're black screened.
We're on black screen.
Scroll down.
Scroll down, then.
You need to move around. Dragon has the map in a tiny corner.
Oh my lord.
I do not.
Yes, you do.
Yes, you do.
You did.
It's right smack in the middle.
No, it's not.
It's in the. It's in a tiny corner.
It is in a tiny corner.
That was not in the middle.
I apologize.
All right, initiative.
Our pumpkin's gone poof.
Select my token, then roll.
Oh, there's two of them. Why are there two of them?
Oh, sorry.
Yeah, please don't do that to us, Firedale. One's already a challenge. Two is just death. Two is we just keep running and never look back.
Don't look back.
We have better odds with the mimics.
My monitor turned back on.
Okay, so out of Colfax and myself, Colfax will be first.
Okay.
Because you have the dex bonus. Oh, and I
did everybody actually roll?
I think we all clicked our tokens this time. Because they're all the same.
Except for Midnight.
Four people.
Except for Meteor.
Sorry.
Ruined.
Well, to be fair, Meteor, I don't think can click on himself because underneath me.
Well, I can. I'm right there.
Yeah, true.
Hang on, I got audio issues.
Oh, God.
Oh, no.
Oh, thank the stars. A chatter saved my booty. You guys are not coming through on
Allie Stream. Uh-oh. Cannot hear us. They're missing all of this banter.
They're like, just a heads up. I was like, oh, chatter to save my booty.
So my monitor that turned off, it does like to turn off randomly, but it usually like instantly reboots. But this time it just didn't.
Is it something with your cable? Did your cable?
I don't think so. I unplugged the cable, replugged it back in.
How's that now, JT?
The power cord, replugged it back in. But it's on now.
Thank you so much. You saved my ass. Usually my chatters don't like to tell me when they can't hear things because they're mean to me.
That's the first thing I will do, and I pop into a channel and I don't hear anything.
Dude, so many times have like I'm ending stream and then they'll tell me, "Oh yeah, we couldn't hear shit," and I'm like, "What?"
I have
audio check viewers. You are the best.
I have a friend. I've had that
happen before, we appreciate you.
I have a friend who straight up tries to tell me that I'm gaslighting him every time it happens.
Alrighty.
If he's in the chat, you know who you are.
The ominous. I you know who you are.
They would know who they are.
Holy shit, do I get to go first?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What you doing? I love today. I usually never get to go first.
Not gaslighting, Meteor. I swear.
We're going to hit it. I'm going to do an unarmed strike.
Uh-huh.
Make sure you don't break your fists.
Remember, you get two attacks.
Yeah, I know. I was looking for the second attack. I lost it.
Remember, paper beats rock.
Wait, hang on.
Are you saying wave the white flag?
I'm surprised I've not seen certain person.
Okay, I'm going to do my unarmed strike.
Baby. Does 18 hit?
18 does hit.
Yeah! Okay, I roll damage now.
Yep, roll damage.
9 damage.
It takes the 9 damage.
What do I do? Roll another unarmed strike, or?
If you want to attack it again, you can. You also have your stunning strike you can activate. You can also spend a point to do your flurry of blows to do 2 more attacks that as a bonus action. It's up to you. You can
point to do my flurry of blows.
Okay. You still get another attack for free as part of your attack action, so.
Oh, so I'll attack again first, and then I'll spend a point.
I totally
roll did. Again.
Totally roll did again. Not just send a message to the person saying you're not in my stream calling Aww. Me out.
Your hand deflects off of it.
Okay, and now I'll spend a key point to do 2 more.
Okay. So roll them both.
There's a 16.
That one hits.
Yay. And then the second one is 18 again.
That one hits. So I need first 2 damages.
7, 6.
You're also cutting out slightly, Allie.
I am?
Yes.
Yes.
I just now heard her say, yeah.
Yep, I heard yeet, and I heard
so each of your blows, the rocks definitely seem to absorb some of it, but you can tell that you cracked some of the stones and things like that. So you were doing damage, just not as much as you feel like you should have been.
Okay, that's all. And I probably cut out because I peaked my mic because I'm too close to it right now. Hang on.
That make you feel better, Fire, the fact that the damage was done?
A little. Not really. I know how these normally work.
Well, would you like to finish your move? You didn't move far. Or do you want to stay there?
I'll move back a bit. So.
Okay, if you move away from it, it has a chance to swat you if it so chooses.
Nah, I'll stay here then.
Okay. Colfax, it is your turn.
Okay. Good question. What do I want to do?
What would you like to do? This thing is pretty stoic, standing there. It's not really moving around a whole lot.
I still want to know why it came in smashing pumpkins. What did the pumpkin ever do to it?
I don't know.
Maybe it's a fan of smashing pumpkins?
I'm gonna...
You can smack me later.
Oh yeah, Dragon Tech... Check GMs. Oh, DMs.
I'm gonna move up here. And then I'm gonna use Draconic Cry. So I have advantage and everyone else has advantage on rolls till my next turn. That's my bonus action and then actual action. Is a fantastic question.
There was a question asked?
No.
Other than the why did they attack us?
No, I am. I am going to myself.
Or the what are we doing?
Yeah.
Well, unless Firedale changed things, talking's free.
Yep, you can talk for a minute free. I mean, you know, don't get cartoonish with it, but if you want to call out or ask stuff or anything like that, that's fine. That'll also give me a minute to look up the thing here for
sure.
Phelan.
I'll do that. So I'll yell at the golem and be like, "Hey, what gives? What are you doing?"
It does not respond.
There's special language for rock?
Rock and roll. I mean, primordial, if people have that, it's the one for, you know, elementals.
If we know it's a golem, then we might realize it's a construct.
If y'all want to, now that you have a moment.
Yeah, we don't know for sure. Ignore the fact that it says Golem of Stones in the turn order. We don't know for sure.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, that's what it looks like.
Yeah.
If everybody would like to roll a knowledge check, knowledge arcana, if you want to try and get an idea, because this is a knowledge thing. Y'all have seen it.
You mean intelligence?
I'll let everyone do that.
Arcana has a.
It's arcana or intelligence if you don't have a bonus.
Okay.
Yeah, it's arcana check.
Intelligence check is the same as an arcana check.
It's if a you don't big have a bonus. Pile of rocks.
Yeah.
You know nothing. Moving on its own.
Colfax may have some idea, but the rest of us are just like, what? Oh, Kalina,
guys,
there you
I think
go.
I see a nose.
I mean, everyone except Kalina is pretty sure it's a pile of moving rubble. Kalina, you're pretty sure it's a construct of some type, but you don't know much more about it.
I'm not going to say it just yet.
Okay. I think the rest of us are a little still kind of startled from the fact that he just came out of nowhere and just smashed.
I want to see what happens after. In the next round part thing. Once we move on.
For some reason, Ellie's sand felon sheet's not showing her her stunning track. Well, there you go. You now have a screenshot of it, so you know what it does. So what shall you do, Colfax? People have talked. People have their knowledge, even though someone's not sharing it. So what do you want to do?
He said what gives, and he's not answering, so...
Yeah, it did not respond.
Mm. Okay.
Ouch, coughing fit.
I'm just thinking here.
Princess is hovering over the thing, looking down on it.
Yeah, how close is Princess to it?
The thing was large. I would say at this point, Princess would be right above it, because Princess would have had to flown up some to get away from hitting the pumpkin, and this thing is taller than the pumpkin was. I mean, it's almost as wide as the pumpkin was, so.
So I'm not going to attack, but I am going to ready and attack with my short sword in case it decides to attack me.
Do you want to move closer to prepare for that, or do you want to stay where you are and have that ready in case it moves closer to you to attack you?
The latter.
Okay.
Okay,
Naya, your turn.
Okay. So Naya's a little bit shaken from what just happened with the pumpkin. She's still trying to figure out what the heck.
Yep, you know? Play some pumpkin debris all over the place. Mm-hmm. I imagine some people are wearing it.
Ruined our chance at roasting some pumpkins for food. It's all over now.
All over.
So Naya's gonna also call out to it. Be like, we would have invited you for breakfast. You didn't have to just make an entrance like that.
It stands there stoically.
Seeing that it's not answering again this time, I'm gonna yell out, it might be a construct.
Then who's commanding it?
I don't know. It's just not answering.
No one has picked up the phone.
Maybe he doesn't want to talk.
Well, then I will go ahead and I will move myself a little closer. I'm going to try to interpose myself between Kalina and the golem.
I was going to try and get closer to you guys.
There.
Yes, I'm going to move here to kind of clear some of the distance.
And this is not difficult terrain, even though it is rocky looking there. That just kind of denotes all the debris and stuff that's made the hill. It is well packed down.
Hold and inflict wounds.
Alrighty. First level. Midnight, it is your turn. Would you like to stay safe and sound in your ring? Or would you like to take an action to pop out? Or whatever it costs you to pop out?
I am going to use a bonus action to pop out of the ring.
Okay. Lena, the ring jumps out of your hand, and Midnight pops out of it in midair, wearing the ring.
I actually pop out like with my finger in the ring, and the ring still in your hand, so I'm kind of holding your hand at the moment.
Nice to see you, Midnight. Weird, but...
Firedale, I forget if Princess was invisible or not when he flew up.
I would assume Princess was not, because you didn't say anything about that for sleepy time.
Yeah. Yeah, you're right. Okay. Well then, I could take my bonus action to even command Princess what to do, so Princess is going to stay there. Midnight is going to cast Phantasmal Force on it, so it needs to roll a intelligence saving throw, please.
What type of damage will this do?
Psychic?
I think it's psychic.
Yeah, okay. Phantasmal Force is psychic damage.
Alrighty. You cast your spell. It's used, and it does not seem to be affected whatsoever.
That means it probably is a construct.
It's a construct! My spell didn't work.
Yeah, that, you like to move?
That was, like, my way of testing it, because it doesn't work on undead or constructs.
Okay, so who's controlling it?
Or it's a zombie. One of the two.
It's an undead rock.
It doesn't look very zombie-like.
I mean there is some moss growing on some of the rocks.
If it's not made any hostile moves, we might just be able to leave.
Okay, so I have 30 feet of movement. I'm gonna go 5...
Midnight doesn't want to hold your hand anymore.
Third. I'm going to go this way. Just to kind of not be in a straight line with everyone.
Uh-huh.
Just in case it has an area attack.
Alina!
So I'm going to bark skin. That's my action. And...
What?
Hmm? What was that?
Nothing. It just actually put Golem of Stones in the turn order.
Yeah?
Yeah, it did.
I mentioned that earlier.
I don't think he was paying attention.
That's why I said never mind the fact that the tracker says Golem of Stones.
Yeah, you're right. In the turn order, yeah.
Yeah.
See, I named the token on the thing, and that's what clicked in my head.
Mm-hmm. I'm just going to move to there.
move to there?
And I bark skin, so that's my turn. I'm not really going to use my bonus. Or my... Yeah, bonus. Because... can't really heal anything.
Okay.
Plus, that's two spells. I can't do that, right?
You can't do two leveled spells.
Yeah, because
so
bark
you can
skin.
Do bark skin.
But yeah.
So and then.
As long as you cantrip at the casting time of a bonus action, then yes.
Okay, then I will shillelagh my
yeah, that's
my
great.
Staff. Mm-hmm.
This very stoic golem blinks its eyes. As far as you can tell, you hear the sound. You see these little rocks moving along its eyelids. There's a green light that flashes out.
Okay.
That looks a lot like the same color that the rocks were before.
Before they turned into mimics.
Did the rocks get together?
Darn.
Let's get together. Yeah.
Wrong thing. Where are you at? Turn into gold. There it is.
So is this a stone mimic? Why is the area green?
And you see a large box.
It's an arena effect.
Around you. That looks vaguely familiar.
Uh-oh.
Did the crystals move?
The crystals have not moved. But it did blink. And as y'all are looking around, noticing this arena, it sucks because y'all did this. I was all set too. Down to the south, you all see another one of these golems.
Uh-oh.
But it's all good.
But it's outside of the area.
Yeah.
So remember what I was saying about two of these being run and don't look back?
Hey, guys. Hey, guys.
I don't think we can run now. Yes.
Guys, my chat's gone from my OBS. How do I bring it back?
Rip.
Oops.
It's a dock.
Pretty sure you... Yeah.
It's a dockable window.
Docks, and then cat.
Okay, thank you. Sorry.
Now, if it was fully gone from docs, then you have to re-log into Twitch through OBS.
No, I just straight up, I accidentally closed it out because I was trying to get rid of a bot that appeared in my chat, and I accidentally closed the chat instead of deleting the message. So I was like, oops.
Not useful.
I was like, well, that's not helpful.
I mean, you don't see the message anymore, but it doesn't really help for the rest of them.
I got rid of the message from the website, but then I was looking at OBS like, shit, oh, I can't see anything. Whoopsies. Okay, continue. I'm so sorry.
We're full of technical difficulties today.
All right, so what's happening now, Fardo?
Blinked and a green, somewhat cuboid thing appeared. Sorry, I couldn't draw a perfect cube. So y'all have more space than should be given.
Okay.
You should.
Phelan, it's your turn.
Oh, of course, it's the one that just fixed technical difficulties, sir.
Wait, okay, I don't want to do that.
Okay. I'm going to do my Draconic Strike, which replaces Unarmed Strike.
You want to fight it when there's two of them?
We don't really have a choice.
Yeah.
I mean, we can attempt to leave the green thing. We don't know if we can yet.
I don't know if we can attempt to leave it, and Phelan's not the type to, like, talk.
Midnight will...
As we've learned.
Midnight's the closest. So either Midnight or Kalina.
I trust Kalina and Midnight to do Kalina, Midnight, and Naya to do the talking because Phelan's not the one with words.
We're getting more of the map.
Yeah, and it looks like Colfax and I are going to burn our ready to actions because they're not going to happen because the thing didn't move in range.
So I'm going to... I'm going to use Draconic Strike, which replaces Unarmed Strike, and I'm changing my damage type to Acid.
Okay.
So instead of normal damage, it does Acid damage this time.
Alrighty.
So here's
go ahead and smack it.
19.
Roll damage.
And then the second one, I'm pretty sure it doesn't.
So far, 16 I've seen was the lowest.
Yeah. Okay.
16 was the lowest.
11 damage.
You hit it with your 16 your
did hit.
Acid.
Okay.
Your acid infused fist here, glowing with green goopy goodness, and the hit lands squarely. And you're pretty sure it took as much damage as you feel like it should have.
Okay.
So it does and, not exist as.
Anything else?
Nah, that's gonna. Well, actually, I'll do a. I'll do a Breath of the Dragon.
Okay.
And I'll.
And what's the save for that?
I'm reading. How do I just roll it so you guys can see it in the chat? Did that do it?
Okay, that'll work too.
Display in V. Okay. Display in VTT.
Oh, there it is. Thank you.
Oh, there you go.
It doesn't say what the DC is. Dexterity saving. Yeah, what's your key DC save? That should be somewhere on your character.
Your
or on that staff? Ability.
My key save?
Yeah.
I don't see.
Oh, 14. I remember seeing that on your thing. So 14.
Oh, okay.
And it's Dex. Yeah. Did that come through? Why you no come through?
Because I ate it. I ate it. Nom, so nom, 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 I ate it so I can attack it.
May roll it twice.
Yeah, it is a 14 Dex. It's next to Breath of
the Threat. Yep, it's under your features and traits. It says it. Key okay. save DC.
Yeah, and DC 14 it is. So it makes the save.
Yep.
Now, equal half as much damage, so you still need to roll damage.
Oh, nice crit.
Nice.
One of them crit.
Yeah, one nice crit.
Now keep getting those crits. Please and thank you.
And you
what
did
damage
acid.
What were you doing again?
Yeah, I did acid damage.
Okay.
Alrighty. It takes the damage.
Okay.
Anything else?
No, that's it.
Colfax, your rated action, your trigger never happened. It blinked.
That's okay.
And it didn't attack you.
That's okay.
I feel like it blinking and creating an arena could have possibly constituted an attack, but...
Yeah, but he wasn't close enough to hit with his
weapon.
The last attack did damage, though, right?
It has been hurt, yes.
Yes. Okay, well, I guess if that's the case, then I'm gonna swiggle in closer here.
And swiggle, swiggle.
Use my primal savagery cantrip.
Okay.
And take a swipe at him.
Okay. Jeez. Okay. That misses.
Okay.
Sorry. Most cantrips tend to be all or nothing.
Yep.
That's fine.
Yeah, and I'm pretty sure our emboldening bond I did last time would have ended no matter who I put it on.
Yeah, that's fine.
Because that was yesterday.
It was that morning when we were escaping.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, was it?
Yeah.
Okay, then it would still be active because this happened immediately after. That was pretty much one round. That's why you only had one action to do.
Oh, that's true. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay, so if it's still going on, it's still going on.
I'll roll again then.
That's a 1d4. You add a d4. Oh, I don't think it's going to be enough.
No, probably not. I'll do it anyways.
Pick your three people. One of them's Colfax.
14 probably won't do it, though.
It's 14 hit.
14 hits.
Hey!
I did Midnight, Kalina, and Colfax. Or Princess. Yeah, I think it was Princess instead of Midnight.
Because Midnight was in the ring.
Yeah. It was Kalina, Princess, and Colfax.
Okay. Yep. Deliver a corrosive attack. Acid damage. Okay.
Yep.
That's 6 damage.
14 hit. Okay.
Mm-hmm.
That's
very yes, 14 cool. hits.
That's good to know. Thank you.
So, it was a really good roll. Good job.
Yay!
Thank you.
And Emboldening Bond did something.
Yay!
Yay!
Yay! All the A's.
So, anything else? Is that just Oh, yeah, that wasn't an attack action. That was a, the cantrip.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm good.
I think that's my turn then, right? If I remember right.
Well, you can continue moving if you want to. You also have a bonus action if you so choose.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, I mean, as long as you don't move out of melee, he doesn't have a chance to take a swipe. You can dance around him.
Okay, yeah, we'll do that. Just gonna move around here. Okay. I am done.
Moving to flanking position.
Yes.
Flank.
Going to the south, you see curl up into a ball.
Okay. That worries me because that's how this other one came in. He curled up and rolled. Oh, dear. All right, so that's Colfax's turn, so that would be my turn now. Yes?
Yes.
Yes.
I was looking at the turn order tracker and saw it hadn't moved, so I was making sure. All right, so I'm going to move in.
Rolled really high. Y'all get to see something.
And then I think to flank, I need to be... There we go. That puts me exactly...
Yeah, anywhere along that right edge will be flanking with anywhere on the left edge.
Okay.
You don't have to be directly across. Like, you could even do it from down here if you wanted to. Just not the exact corner. Because
mechanics.
I didn't
want to waste too much of my movement, so I'd probably be here then if that counts.
Go to the right one. Because that's kind of its space. There you go.
Oh, okay. I wanted to make sure it was within 10
Yeah,
range.
It's squarish. All the pogs are always circular, but it, you know, consider it a square.
Okay.
So yeah, okay. you're
so
good
it is
there.
In that square. All right.
Yeah.
Then I am going to... Let's see, I've got... What are my bonus actions here?
Forgot. I now know why I couldn't select that. It's because it was a drawing.
I see.
Wait, did the golem get a new initiative?
There are two of them.
Yeah, but the golem in front of us was after Kalina before. And now it's...
There's another unknown creature, though, after me.
But that should be the one...
That's so funny.
Yeah, there was nothing between Colfax and me in an or initiative, or between
yeah,
me
see,
and
I re-
initiative.
I just added one for the other one, and it's the one that got 17, but now the other one that used to say Golem of Stones now says unknown creature.
Okay, so yeah, so the one
that's
17
what he's talking
is the
about.
One, is supposed to be the one at the bottom.
Okay.
Yeah.
That
okay.
confused me.
Yeah, it confused me too when she said it. It's like, no, it didn't get an extra one. Oh, okay. Yeah, I see
it,
what happened.
It just swapped them for some reason.
Yeah.
I just knew there wasn't anything before me in initiative before.
All right, so I am going to do an inflict wounds.
All righty.
So I'm going to do my melee swipe and hit him through my mace.
Yep, and you do get advantage.
Okay. So let me do the thing that lets me do advantage. Here we go. And I'm going to do this at second level.
Ooh.
25. Nice.
So, damage, 13 necrotic?
Yes, 13 necrotic damage.
It seems to be damaged by your necrotic energy there quite well.
Okay.
As normal,
more than
I should
usual
say.
Or as much as usual.
As normal.
Okay.
That's good.
Anything
I don't
else?
Think anyone's taken damage, so I don't need to bonus action healing word yet. Do you have a little bit more movement? I'm gonna risk it, actually. I'm gonna attempt to move out of its range and see if it takes a swipe.
Alrighty.
I'm just gonna...
Okay, it does attempt to take a swipe at you.
Okay. That's gonna hit.
I am silvery barbsing that, thank you.
Okay.
That's good, because that was a crit.
It's not green like a crit.
Because the dice roll is hidden.
Mm.
Oh, yeah. No clue. Right,
so try that again.
You have to re-roll. Okay.
Yep. I did it again.
And who is getting the advantage, Kalina? You can award the advantage to somebody.
I will give it to Midnight, since Midnight's next.
Okay. So that won't hit me.
Which one to the south, you see a foot extend from the boulder-like body of it and push itself off hard enough that it starts rolling to the south and into the distance.
Okay.
Out of sight. Over the hills and through the woods.
To grandmother's house we go.
I'll move back.
Kalina, watch out. It might be visiting your Nana.
Don't say that. Nana doesn't like rocks.
Over the mountains through the woods. Back in my chair,
I turned over so fast. Like, oh.
That's how this works.
So it is your turn, Midnight.
Okay. I thought there was a marker for advantage. Let's see it. First, I'm going to keep facing the golem, but I'm going, seeing this green wall appear right behind me, I'm going to back up into it and try and press my back up against it, see if it gives any resistance.
It feels extremely resistant.
Okay. That is good information.
It feels very cool to the touch and has that same green shimmer that y'all saw last night.
We can't get through the wall! Is solid.
Now we're stuck in a barrier.
Its eyes are still glowing green.
Is magic stuck in it?
What do you mean, is magic stuck in it?
Throw a cantrip out of it and see if the magic passes through.
From our
because yesterday physical yesterday... things could technically pass through.
Mm-hmm.
Seemed like
true,
but magic couldn't. And if you physically can't pass through right now...
Yeah, we couldn't physically pass through either before, though. We were blocked.
But throwing a rock went through.
Rocks and sticks could go.
Yeah, inanimate objects could pass through.
Alright, so... Then I'm going to... I guess for Princess's mouth... What does he say? I'm casting Hideous Laughter.
Tasha's Hideous Laughter?
Yeah. Nice. So he'll need to roll a wisdom save.
What's your spell save, DC?
15 for that.
Okay.
Dang it, I have to look this up.
Why is it?
Gotta look up your stone golem's wisdom.
Oh, it's because it's not my. It's a bard spell. That's why.
Huh. It says a creature makes a wisdom throw. Okay.
Yeah.
It does affect constructs.
Constructs are still creatures.
17 succeeds.
Hey, it does not fall into a fit of laughter, but it does giggle just a tiny bit.
You look like a pebble! What? Is that not funny?
Um.
Yeah, so that fails.
That sounds a little grating.
that also means that it does have an intelligence score of more than 4. So it is not dumb as a sack of rocks.
Oh, I thought it was intelligence. I mean, wisdom.
It is a wisdom save, but a creature with an intelligence score of 4 or less is not affected by it.
Oh, it's not affected then. I did not hear that part.
Mm. Oh. Okay.
So it's dumb as a sack of rocks.
Well, and metagaming, it has an intelligence of 3.
None of my stuff affects it. So with my bonus
action. It's almost like it's a construct.
My bonus action, I'm going to have Princess come over and land on Colfax's head. And.
It has already used its reaction.
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Hello.
I would technically be like here, just on top of Colfax.
Yep, burned its reaction, so y'all can run.
So yeah, there. You can put me underneath of Colfax so that Colfax is.
You can hold alt and move yourself specifically if you ever want to do something like that.
How do you do it like that?
Then you can right click on it and say like to back.
We cannot do that.
You can't do the to back to front?
No.
Oh, okay.
We can alt to not.
You can't alt to move though.
Be in a square. Yeah.
Yeah.
And so Princess is going to just kind of be a second set of eyes for Colfax and kind of like try and help correct his aim, like 10 degrees up, 5 degrees to the left, and it's going to use the help action.
Well, and y'all are emboldening bonded, so as long as the two of you.
So he'll have both advantage and be able to roll a d4.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, as long as y'all are within 30 feet.
Yep. So, Colfax, your next thing will have advantage and an additional d4.
Hello.
So that was your bonus action?
Yep.
Hello.
Anything else?
Do I want to move? I think I want to move 10, 15, 20, 30 here.
And?
That's it.
No action? Oh no, you did the laughter.
Yeah, I did an action.
Kalina, it is your turn.
I am going to move there. And. Okay. I am going to attempt an ice knife. Looks like I hit.
24 to
hit. Okay, you hit with the 24. Anything around, I think, is what would be the DC 14. Is it all creatures or just certain?
I think the DC is for the bonus cold damage, maybe, but
target, let's see. And each creature within 5 feet of it must
it's other creatures.
Ow.
So are you sure you want to do that?
Because it would target everybody else here.
Yeah, then nope.
Okay.
That's an interesting question, though, because it's so big, so if it explodes...
Within five, it is within 5 feet of it.
Yeah.
So it is. It's not where it was targeted. It's of the creature.
That's interesting.
So everywhere around it has little shards that would blow off.
The bigger the creature it hits, the bigger the explosion.
Yep.
It's like a dog meteor shaking off water.
Yep.
It's shaking off the needles, and the needles are trying to hit everybody else.
And it won't do a wisdom save, so I guess all I can do is try to. I can throw.
It can make a wisdom save.
Yeah, it just doesn't have intelligence over 4.
Yes, that's why that spell didn't work, is because it doesn't affect things with an intelligence less than 4.
Yeah, it still makes wisdom saves.
Yeah.
I'm just gonna end up... Oh, no. Wait, can I? Ah!
Oh, can you?
Produce flame. I can throw the flames, right?
Yes.
30 feet. Okay, I'm going to try to produce flame. Yep, I probably don't hit.
13? You throw it, and that misses. But remember, you're one of the people...
You're emboldening bonded, but I'm not in it, so she does not.
Oh, you have to be in it? I thought it was whenever whoever is emboldened and bonded.
I choose three. It's any of the three. I didn't choose myself.
Which is Princess, Colfax, and me.
And Kalina. Kalina's not within 30 feet of those two.
Oh, yeah, I was thinking Midnight. I'm sorry.
I don't really have many other attacking spells.
That's why usually put it on myself, but...
So yeah, you throw it and the flame kind of bounces off a rock that you just barely got the edge of. Doesn't seem to do anything. And that should be your turn.
Yeah, well, it can't really do anything else. And nobody's hurt, so...
I mean, you might have a little bit of movement left, but I wasn't sure.
I'm trying to stay away from it.
Well, yeah, but you could have moved further up or back.
Trying to stay away from the wall a little bit.
Okay, fair enough.
It raises one arm and slams down towards Phelan.
Does that hit? Allie?
No, it does not.
Okay, and it raises its other arm and slams down towards... Well, Princess is on top, so... Princess. It misses. It rolled a 1.
Okay. That means it has a +4 to attack.
Great. That's Phelan, not good. That's not working.
It's your turn.
Excuse me.
Was that a hiccup?
Great turn, great turn, great turn.
It was a little hiccup burp.
Professional streamers, yes.
It means it has quite a lot of strength if it has a +4 to its melee.
Yeah.
That's a 20 strength roll. That's scary.
Shit, I lost it. Give me a second to rebind it. Okay, we're going to Draconic Strike with the acid again.
Okay.
Is that first one? Ooh.
Oh, no.
8 does not hit.
That's an actual 1. That misses. Even adding the d4 won't help you, because 1...
That one does.
That hits. Balance. Yeah.
That one does not hit.
So roll the damage.
I don't know what the crit damage is.
It's just hit the pink thing.
Just, yeah, hit the pink button. It should do it for you.
What pink button? There's no pink button.
The attack button in the chat for that.
In roll 20 chat.
It says Draconic Strike in pink.
Oh.
There you go.
Yeah.
Did you not know that you 15. Could do that?
I didn't.
Okay.
Yeah, that's what we've been doing.
Yeah, that's what I've been doing this entire time.
So. A crit is a second roll of the damage dice.
Yeah, it just rolls the damage dice again. It's not doubling.
Okay,
it's
so
just
you...
another roll of the dice. That's the roll we turn on at the beginning.
Go ahead.
I want to spend another key point to do it again.
Okay, give me just a moment.
Okay.
Phelan swings her hand at it with the intent of doing this nice acidic strat and lands a clean hit and rocks fly off.
And it moves.
It got smaller.
Yep. It got smaller.
It's out of range until you move closer again.
So yeah, the more we damage it, the smaller it gets?
So you can move.
We're breaking pieces.
Yep, now you're close enough.
Dang,
so now you're going to do your flurry of blows.
So did that damage us? Do we need to roll a dex save or anything?
No,
she targeted it specifically.
Yeah, rocks have flown off of it. It got smaller. Those rocks were laying on the ground. There was no, they didn't explode from it. It has shrunk.
It just crumbled
much.
Off of the bottom.
Okay.
Oh, that was almost a crit again.
Flying at us.
Good job. Roll damage for both.
Nice. Very nice.
Now these hit a little bit softer. Because these are just bludgeoning.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You've done 31 damage this round.
Yeah. Good job.
Hey, guys, I'm finally doing stuff. Usually in battles, I get, like, incapacitated the first fucking round.
I just had a thought.
Cold facts.
Yes.
If we target its face and its eyes, could we make the arena go away?
Maybe. We could try. Cold shots are usually a higher AC to hit. It might be harder. It's a smaller target.
It was a potential thought, though.
Mm-hmm.
Cold facts.
Yep. Hey, guess what? I'm going to do Primal Savagery again.
Uh-huh. Going to slash at it?
You have advantage?
Yes.
I think you need to get closer, though.
Yeah, you got to get closer again, because when he shrunk, he moved out of range.
Ew, okay. All right. I missed that part.
14 hits.
All right.
Roll damage.
Roll
again, just in case you get the crit.
Oh, yeah, you might crit.
19.
So no crit. So, yeah, so roll the damage.
Also, you still have your d4 because you're within 30 feet of Princess. You can add that to the attack damage.
We will do that.
Or think. No, it's attack roll, ability check, saving throw. Never mind.
Okay. I was wait a minute. That's a little bit powerful.
Not damage. It's not the bardic inspiration.
That's why I was so surprised by it. I was like, huh.
Yeah, okay. I was like, hold on, I misread.
I didn't realize you could do that. Okay, but oops. 10. 10 will do it.
There we go.
Yeah, if you don't think you're going to have to do a saving throw, you can always use it on your roll to hit.
Why was there a yellow box around Naya?
Don't worry about it.
You're being targeted.
Don't worry about it. It's fine.
You're getting smaller.
I did not draw the yellow box.
Colfax hit it, and the blow went through it and threw rocks off the backside of it.
Yep. And I moved a little bit, and that's my turn.
Alrighty. Naya, it's your turn.
Okay. So seeing that he is actively shrinking down...
That's something!
Mm-hmm. I am going to, from where I'm at, cast a first level Guiding Bolt.
Alrighty.
Is it still advantage or normal?
You're way over there, so normal.
Okay.
The reason Colfax had advantage is because Princess did the help action.
Ah, okay. That's what I was trying to double check, because I know the turn before there was advantage for a different reason. Okay.
Midnight has advantage because of the silvery barbs.
Right.
Had.
No, but previously Colfax did a thing where everybody had advantage for the turn.
Oh.
Previously. Yeah. It was at the beginning. It's fine. So I'm going to send a guiding bolt and hope it hits.
It hits.
Everyone is so close to doing well. I mean, really, really well. That hits.
So close to getting there.
So that is 15 radiant damage.
You shoot that and blow off nearly all the rocks. This thing is rather large now. It's got little scrawny arms now that are made of a few rocks here and there. And right smack in the middle is a glowing green crystal that looks a lot like the ones that were in the little spires surrounding the area out.
And you'll see Naya breathe a sigh of relief, because this is the first guiding bolt she has cast that hasn't killed something.
Yeah, and that is what's glowing now, as the head has been blown off. It has little scrawny legs, little scrawny arms.
first time she's cast a guiding bolt and it hasn't fallen down dead.
Da-ta-ta.
Finally, she's not 3 for 3. Okay. So I still have my movement and my bonus action.
Mm-hmm.
So I am going to move closer. And I don't... Has anyone taken damage yet?
I don't think so.
No.
No.
Then I am not going to...
Healing Word.
The couple times it's attacked, it's missed.
Oh! Well, hold on. I'm going to go back where I was, roughly. I'm going to bonus action face step. Okay. I'm going to face step right into its face and hit it with some fire.
Okay.
Do my summer fire damage.
And the save is, or is it just direct damage?
It is just 3 direct fire damage. Only 3.
Okay.
Every creature of my choice that I can see after I use my face step takes the fire damage.
That's nice.
It's not much damage, but it's guaranteed.
All right, I need to move it there. You knock off all the rest of the stones, and there's just a...
You cut
crystal.
Out...
Crystal. Green crystal.
Hello?
Hi.
Yeah.
Did I cut out?
Yes.
You did.
Yes, you did.
Okay. You blow the rest of the normal rocks off of it onto the ground. All you see now is just the green crystal there kind of wiggling back and forth. Hopping on the ground.
Okay.
Naya's going to narrow her eyes down at him and be like, somebody grab that crystal, but be careful. That's her turn.
Midnight.
Guys, where'd the other one go?
I don't know.
It rolled off in the other direction. It may come back, so maybe we should finish this and move?
How big is the crystal, Firedale?
It's a rather large crystal. I'd say about 3 feet. 3x3.
Okay. I am going to come up to here. I'm gonna open my bag and
how big does the bag open again?
Well, bags not fit in your bag. 2 feet opening.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a 3 foot.
Yep, they will.
Too small.
Yep, your bag mouth can only hold something about 2 feet wide. This is 3.
It tries to nom on it, but it can't take it.
Yep.
Dang. Question. Can we possibly dispel magic on it?
I don't think we have dispel magic.
Yes, we do.
Well, she might.
I do.
Okay. Yeah.
Would dispel magic work?
It's always worth a shot.
It's one of my highest level spells, though, so I'm wondering would it work or not.
Yeah, it's like, do you want to do that, or can we just crack it and be done, you know?
Yeah.
We may not need to dispel magic, we just break it.
If it doesn't fit in the bag, then I'm thinking break it.
Eldritch blast it.
Because it would have been nice to be able to take it out and have a portable enclosure anytime we want, but it doesn't fit.
Assuming that's how it works, what if it possesses whatever's near it and we just create new enemies every time we put it down?
Oh yeah, imagine your bag of gnawing suddenly attacking you in the middle of the night.
Yeah, like, I don't like it.
No.
I like it.
Nope.
Okay, well then...
It's a great idea.
In that case...
Pick it up or break it.
I am going to cast Eldritch Blast at it. Which is going to be at disadvantage because I'm so close, right?
If it's a ranged spell attack, then yes.
But then I also have advantage on it, so it's going to be a straight roll. And when I cast Eldritch Blast, I do two... So do I roll twice? I do two blasts.
It attacks twice?
Yes, at fifth level, I get two beams. So I don't know if that means I roll twice, or the first roll just hits twice.
It normally I think it's
you
say...
could target one thing with both, or two with one. I'm checking.
Yeah, let me pull it up.
Two beams at fifth level. Yeah, each beam is
separate attack roll for each beam.
Oh yeah, there it is.
At the it does say it at the end.
Yep. I didn't read far enough. Okay, so one, two.
Okay.
I assume both hit.
Well, 14 did hit, so yes.
The second one is probably at disadvantage, though. Right? The first one was the one that had advantage.
Getting advantage because of flanking? Or
no, the silvery barbs.
Ah, yeah, your silvery barbs.
So then the second one would be at disadvantage. But so it's a 14.
So it's still 14. Yeah.
Okay, so both hit. So roll damage for the first, roll damage for the second. That is
plus so we've got 12 force plus 3 bludgeoning damage. And then 13 force and 3 bludgeoning.
Yep.
Because the bludgeoning, I think it's resistant.
So 31 damage, Firedale.
Firedale, are you muted? We can't hear you.
Uh-oh.
Curse to Firebutt.
Oh. I just saw an orange exclamation mark next to his name.
Oh. Can you hear me?
Now we can.
Yeah, that was weird.
What happened? Did the art
suddenly everyone went quiet, and so I looked at my phone, and everything was fine. So I restarted Discord and went to join back, and saw that I was still in the call. So I joined the call. And,
Okay.
Yep.
Okay.
So 31 damage.
Yeah. So the 21
that
hit.
Was bludgeoning.
Magical bludgeoning.
Still bludgeoning. Yeah.
Okay. So the 21 hit. With the first beam, and the crystal falls to the ground inert. The second beam strikes it, reflects off into the sky.
Okay.
Because it's no longer a creature.
Yep.
So there's a large, green, dark crystal there. Let me check the info.
Does the arena go poof?
Because I know Naya sees it. I need to see if anyone else does. Naya, Midnight, Kalina, and Phelan, all three looking down at this crystal, you see what appears to be an etching on it. And if you look closer, you can see what it says.
Okay, I would like to attempt to read it.
Are we still in turn order, or can I come and look?
No. Combat is over at the moment.
Everybody can come up.
Did you say Midnight sees it or no?
Also, at the same time that it falls inert, the box disappears.
Okay, so what are we rolling to? Do we need to roll to see if
there's
we can try to read?
A rune or something etched in it, and we're trying to see what it is.
That's what I'm asking. Do
give me an investigation check. It's very small and tiny, so you got to squint to see it, so let's see if you can see it.
Can I dig through my farrier's tools and see if I have, like, a magnifying glass or something in there I can use?
Unfortunately, there weren't any with the farrier's tools.
Darn it!
Now, if you had a jewelry maker's tools, probably.
Darn it! This
will give you the help action.
Okay.
Gonna come over and land on your head.
So everyone kind of groups up and squints around this rock and tries to get in close.
And I'll offer guidance to Kalina, since Kalina's also trying. which is a D4.
So add all your bonuses there, Kalina.
I've got a 13, or... Oh, I have to roll with advantage. Hold on.
14 for me.
I have to roll again, because advantage. 15.
The 15 is enough? Just a second. I had to stand up and move.
Unprofessional.
Looking at it, it seems to be a set of runes written in common. There are some that appear to be magical there. The magic has apparently faded. You know these from your clerical background. However, what you can see, it says property and protector of Novell.
Oops. Well, Novell might be mad at us now.
Well, it attacked us, so I don't think he'll be... I think he'll be at least somewhat understanding.
I thought they were a threat.
Well, we can try to drag it back with us to Novell on our way.
Maybe we should get out of here before the other one shows up again.
I think that's a good idea. We don't think we want to be here if the other one shows back up again.
Can I put the broken pieces in my bag? Will they fit now?
All the stones that fell off of it?
No, the broken crystal.
No, the crystal.
No, it just fell inert. It didn't crack or break.
Oh, okay.
Well, if you'd like to try and break it apart, that would be fine. You can use the farrier's tools and give me a check.
No, I don't want to break it apart.
I don't want to break it.
If it's still intact, that's good.
Y'all have lots of stones littering the ground now. Some of them look like they're river rocks. A few of them just look like normal quartz and things like that. You know, random rocks thrown around. Nothing of value as far as you can tell.
How heavy is this crystal?
You try and pick it up?
Yep.
Mm-hmm.
It's very light.
Very light? Okay.
Yeah, as in Princess could even pick this up with one claw. One talon.
Yeah, I think we want to bring it with us.
Then Princess is going to pick it up and fly overhead.
Yeah, this thing is so light, it's, you know, it really shouldn't be that light. Almost paper light. You know, it still has some weight to it. You can tell it's there, but it's definitely a lot lighter than you feel like it should be.
Okay.
Yes. So Princess fixed it up.
Yep.
Everybody's stomach growls a little bit. The combat is over. What will you do?
We should make our way back over to where the signs were.
I'll pass out some rations while we walk.
You
Since
don't,
stomachs are growling.
You don't want a good berry yet today?
Thank you.
I mean, you want a good berry right now? I was not going to force it.
Sorry, I was kind of dealing with tape.
They wouldn't assume. They're your good friends. You know that. They don't want to take advantage of you.
Right. It's like you didn't say anything about good berrying without prompting, so I didn't want to prompt.
Good berry. Hand out.
Okay.
That's nice, because I was technically down one health.
Yeah, from feeding the pumpkin.
Yeah.
Woo! So everyone feels much more fed now after that rigorous morning workout, in which nobody took any damage. Grr. Oh, wait. Yay! Y'all did really well. So... where are y'all heading? Y'all gonna head back towards the
towards the signs,
to
yeah.
Two of my spells.
Yep, so y'all head back towards the signs. Now, you didn't travel far away before because the night had come down so far, but you did travel far enough to where they weren't visible anymore. So we'd say about an hour back. You know, it wasn't very long, but it was out of sight.
Yeah, we were just moving out of sight range of them so that they would stop attacking the barrier. Yep.
So y'all get back to where the green spires are. planted around in the areas where they were before, you see the signs where they had moved back into position before you had left. The two that were by the side have moved back. You see a few broken arrows laying on the ground. I think they were both arrows. Maybe an arrow and a bolt.
Crossbow bolts, yeah.
Yeah. Just laying on the ground.
Princess up in the air is going to be keeping an eye out for if it sees that other golem coming back.
Okay.
I will pick up one of the bolts and put it back in my sack.
It is cracked.
Aww.
It has been broken off. The tip is missing.
I will burn my channel divinity for a long rest, and I'll regain my second level spell slot.
Okay. While y'all are standing there and pondering what to do, in the distance, Princess sees a big stone boulder. However, it seems to be rolling parallel to where you all are instead of at you, like going south to north. Whereas y'all are eastward of it, it rolls very fast on by, south to north, and on down the meadow plains there.
Did we just happen to be in its path of
very possible monitoring? Might have just been in the patrol path.
So,
but we tried to leave and it didn't let us. It tried to take swipes. So,
so all the signs are still there, right?
Yes, but yeah. They've mostly spread back out along the path. Some of them are standing on the path, you know, whereas before all of them were next to it. Give me just a minute, and I will switch the map over if you want me to.
Yes, yeah, please.
Okay, one moment.
I don't necessarily want to fight them all.
I would like to try and find Leo.
Of course
I would
do.
Like to look for a figure dressed as a sign with shoes.
Just like someone who's like very
doing that, I'll be right back.
Poorly, very poorly dressed.
Like a sign with a shoe.
Yes.
Oh, fire butt went poof.
Yep.
Man, he ain't getting no luck today.
Oh, there we go. There's some out. One problem at a time. Well, he's muted. He's actively muted.
Oh,
yeah, that's not. Oh, okay. I was about to say it'd be awkward if he didn't know he was muted.
No, he's actively muted.
Okay. Hello, testing. Can you hear me?
Hi.
I think my cheek is maybe pressing buttons when I'm not looking or something here.
Don't do that.
Your butt that's... cheek.
Stop no, my butt dialing cheek. Things.
He doesn't have us on speakerphone.
I'm just here causing trouble. That's all.
But that's what you're supposed to do, isn't it?
Okay. So we're back. The round stones are nowhere to be seen, so I will get rid of them.
Oh, beautiful. I was about to ask.
And I don't think the signs are red anymore.
I mean, y'all saw them before. You're pretty sure that they were enemies at some point.
Yeah, but was there a sign in the middle of the road?
Yes, that one moved back there and stayed.
Okay.
So the sun is up. You see what you see there. Now, you said, what were you looking for, Naya?
I was looking for the figure that called out to us last night. That was the sign dressed, the sign with shoes.
Uh-huh.
That was up by the tree.
Right now, you don't see anything of the sort.
Okay.
And I am looking for Leo.
Signs kind of have pairs. You don't see any that have any arrows or bolts sticking out of them, though.
It's this one.
So you move up in the space there again, walking through where the wall is. Feels kind of weird. You feel like sticky all over for a moment while you're in it, and then it's gone after you walk out the other side. None of the signs seem to react as far as you can tell.
How big is the sign?
It's about 10 feet tall, you know, like a half a foot wide. It's a tall, like, wooden post that has the sign on the front of it, like, partway up the post.
Naya is really tempted to ask Kalina to produce flame and just light one of them on fire.
I'm gonna give Princess the bag, and Princess is gonna fly up to the top of it and start shoving the bag down on top of it.
Okay, well, first, you have to drop the stone if Princess is gonna pick something else up.
Right.
Yep.
Princess will drop the stone. Here.
Princess drops the stone next to Naya.
Naya will pick it up.
Okay, Naya has a green inert stone. Then Princess is going to pick up the bag and start going down over top of the sign.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, is this the bag of gnawing?
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Now, is it going to bite? Is it going to bite at
roll damage?
Yeah.
It's a creature that's not you reaching into the bag.
Fair. let me see. What is it? 1d6.
Now, strangely enough, as you're trying to put the post into the bag starts gnawing on it. Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
And the sign disappears into the bag as the bag hits the ground.
Okay.
All of Meteor stuff is going to turn into mimics now in the bag.
I am terrified.
I'm saying nothing.
Naya would kind of like to make a quick stop at each of those posts that we had seen previously with the green gems and make sure none of the gems are missing.
Looking up and down the path?
Yeah.
Okay. So, checking that one, you actually see at the bottom of it where an inset, you know, where the smaller crystals are kind of poking out of the ground, one of them seems to be missing, and it's a rather large circular area. It's about 3 feet wide.
Does it match the approximate size of the one I have in my hand?
Approximately, you could say that. There's also one missing from the one to the south.
Okay.
Down here.
Well, I think I know where these came from.
Now, is there missing in any of the
Naya's
other ones?
Going to attempt to put it back into the podium, the one to the north.
You attempt to put it back in, it seems to slot in perfectly.
Okay.
You let it go as it sets in, and it starts to glow softly with the same green light that the crystal there has now. You know, it's not super bright or anything. You know, it's just a dim glow. It matches the rest of them that are there now.
Okay. Cool. No harm done.
It's recharging, potentially. Yep.
Let's keep moving.
Let's get out of this weird area, please.
Mm-hmm. So Naya's going to press on now that she's not burdened by a large crystal.
Yeah, so now you all get to feel that eerie, sticky feeling as you walk through the path of kind of where the crystals connect each other. And it doesn't feel good at all, but it's immediately gone after you're through it.
It's almost as bad as the feeling of falling asleep, but not quite.
Eh, I'd say falling asleep's still a lot worse.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you make it through just fine. None of the signs seem to react to you moving nearby. So, y'all going to go north or east?
One of us knows the path. I forget who.
Colfax.
So, we didn't see anyone dressed as a sign?
We did not.
Nope, not yet.
And he was like,
y'all have looked around
originally, right?
Mm-hmm. Yep.
I think yep, he was we're beyond the tree. To go east, but I don't remember. I haven't looked at that map today.
Colfax
It should be east because north is going to bring us to.
Yeah, north up, should have sent us up towards other places.
So, yeah, I think east. Would we have had a map?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's going to bring us towards Strighton and Marsund.
Yeah, we want to go east then.
You don't want to go there?
Not yet.
I'll go to Marsund.
Okay. Well, Marsund's out the way right now. So we need to hit Novale first. We're closer.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, and then we can turn around.
Get some rest.
Yeah. Get us sleep in a bed.
Maybe get some information.
Y'all start heading down that path to the east. You're traveling for a little bit, an hour or so, and off to the right, you see a rather small hut, and it is right adjacent to the road that you're walking on. I don't have a map for it. I apologize.
Did you say road there is or a rug? Small
road.
I heard rug.
Next to the road you all are walking on. As you all are walking, you do occasionally see some more weird signs. Some of the signs seem to be like halfway to a transformation. Pretty much as far as you can tell, in our world, it would be like a game of telephone. Right up next to the actual sign that was there warning you, those ones look somewhat close. The further along you even start getting ones that are not signs at all, but just kind of haphazardly tilted pieces of wood in the middle. Intelligently, without making a roll for it, you're pretty sure all of these are fake signs.
There might be a real one.
And these are all along the road. Occasionally in the distance, you also do see a really weirdly shaped tree. Things like that. And then you have this cottage here, this small hut that you're coming up onto. It's not very big at all. It has a large piece of wood laid out in the back that's actually bigger than the hut. Hammered wood, like a floor that's been just laid on the ground. And little bits of smoke coming out of a strangely wooden chimney. The smoke is extremely thin. Doesn't look like it's from a fire at all. Y'all are about to come up on the hut. Anything catch your eye? Y'all want to do anything or walk on by?
I wonder if that's our stranger.
Possibly.
Yeah. I want to investigate the hut.
Midnight. Go ahead.
Sorry, no, you go ahead.
I was going to say, Midnight walks up to the door. And looks around the hut. Where are you going to? Okay, so Midnight looks cautiously around the hut. Did you give Princess back the crystal before Naya took it? Then Naya took it and placed it, so y'all don't have to worry about the crystal anymore. Okay. So Princess is free to move around, because I know you like to explore with Princess, which is why I was asking.
Yes, Princess is going to fly up and see if she sees anyone around the hut.
Okay, going around the hut, there are several windows in the hut. Nearly the top half of every wall is one or two windows of various shapes and sizes. Some are round, some are square. Fewer are, just trapezoidal, not exactly straight. And everything else, the door, as far as you can tell, doesn't seem like it fits perfectly in the jam. Sorry about that. Had to cough.
Nice.
There's no... Go ahead.
Yeah. I was gonna say, Naya's halfway worried we're gonna have a hut mimic.
Is there any part of the hut, like chimney and a door edge piece of the window, that could fit in the bag a little bit?
You're trying to
maybe
take the
corner of a roof.
No, he's trying to test if it's a mimic, see if the bag gnaws on it.
Maybe the corner of a roof.
Can I give my bag to the princess and have him try that?
You see, certainly can.
If my bag starts gnawing on it.
You certainly can.
I would like to do that. Still invisible, so the bag would be invisible as well.
Yeah, so y'all see this floating bag of gnawing go up and like land on the edge of the roof. You hear a few wood chips being nibbled on as it bites against the roof.
Oh.
Okay.
I fly back.
So the door has a rope that's hanging on it. And suddenly the door slams open because it's been alerted. And inside, just inside the door, as Princess is flying back down, is a sign that looks like it's half person, half sign. There's a shoe on the bottom of the sign piece, and this person's head seems like it's melded with the sign slightly. His tongue is hanging way out of it, and his tongue seems to be rather large for a person. The person half looks like it used to be dwarven, maybe. There's a little scruff of a beard, but it is very much signpost with, you know, like a third of a human attached to it, as far as you can tell. You know, a third of a dwarf.
Naya's half wondering what Spellpert magic would do to this guy.
Yeah, so he slams open the door and then looks out, you know, kind of alarmedly for a moment, and then seems relieved and happy at the same time. He goes, "Hello!" As his partial dwarven mouth and huge sign mouth open to greet you.
Who might you be?
Guys, I'm pretty sure the house is a mimic.
Colfax lets out, like, what can only be described as, like, the scream of a 3-year-old girl.
So, Princess said this loud enough for people to hear?
Princess hushedly says it to the group.
Okay. And what did you say, Fire?
Naya asked pretty loudly, who might you be?
I'm going from Noville.
Something from Noville.
Who from Gorge. Noville?
Gorge.
Gorge? Or George?
Yes, Gorge.
Oh.
Right. Why have you become rather sign-like, sir?
He gets like a half sad look in one eye. The sign has three eyes that open up and look kind of saddened as well. And he said,
"The mythic is saying who wants. Turns you into whatever you're next to."
I got none of that.
Could you just... Sure. Hold on. I think I'll speak George now. He said, "The mist turns you into whatever you are next to."
If you stay too long.
If you stay too long?
That.
If you stay too long. Okay. I thought he said something about a bone.
Is the effect in the entire area?
That's for the most part, just past Noville.
Just past Noville.
Is the area of Noville itself safe?
They built the house to keep away from the mist.
I'm sorry, I didn't
understand. If y'all have any trouble understanding me, I'll let you roll. I'm sorry about this.
Yeah,
this guy.
My brain can't right now.
It's okay.
My brain cannot.
Princess, can you translate?
It's easy. It's easy to to fill out there. He said they built it up to stay away from the mist. You want me to stop and just talk normal?
No, no, no. Please continue.
I'm too tired for this. I cannot parse.
Yeah. Now, there is one part, though, that I've got to say this way, so I apologize. Oswald told me you come give stuff together.
Artur told me you would come.
Wait, Artur?
You know Artur?
Yes. Yes.
Give
he
what?
Said, girl with, he said, girl with gentleman neck, you group I should give.
Something, something, something give.
Girl with gem in neck, you group should
yes.
give.
And he points directly at Drema.
Yep.
With his dwarven hand.
He can see the gem in her neck.
Wait, you can see the gem in her neck?
I can.
Most people have not been able to. See it. How do you see it?
Arthur says because I'm close to monster.
Wait.
Oh.
Oh.
Are we monsters? Have we been monsters this whole time?
Well, there are definitely some questions about you, Midnight.
Yeah, so he said, he told him he can see it because he's close to monsters. Now I'll talk normal. I just had to get that out there.
Okay.
And then he says, come, and walks out of this hut and starts waving with the one arm. He seems to be, the sign part of him is rather stiff, but he still seems like he can bend it at the hip a little bit. And he hobbles almost like he's on, a partial stilt or like someone who's got a fake leg on and still isn't quite used to wearing it. And he beckons you all to the back of his hut.
George, I don't know if you are aware of this, but I'm pretty sure your house is a mimic too.
He nods his head and he says, yes, nearly everything around these parts are, but you're safe during the day, they don't move.
That's very strange.
At night, before the mist occurs, you have to be careful. That's what the gate is for. And he motions towards
the barrier.
Yeah, that direction. Yeah.
Well, I'm glad we put that gem back then.
Yeah, things can get in, but nothing out.
Okay.
Well, and Naya's feeling a little alarmed, saying with them saying that they built Novale up to avoid it, and we shouldn't travel at night. Can we make it to Novale before nightfall at this point?
Probably not before nightfall at this point.
I don't want to sleep in the mist.
You can probably make it tomorrow.
I don't want to sleep in the mist.
How do we survive in here during the night?
We don't move. He says, act like them, act like a sign. Don't move.
And don't be
most of them are stupid.
So that we don't turn into something?
What'd you say?
It should take a long time for that.
Okay.
So yes.
Well, because he said if you turn into whatever you're next to, if you stay long enough. I wasn't sure if one night was long enough.
Yeah.
How long is a long time?
I was tied up by bandits and my stuff was stolen to a sign and it took me 3 days.
3 days.
That seems bad. Okay. So not for nothing, but we should probably make this visit quick.
Yeah, there are still plenty of high mounds and everything here that you can see dotted about. And he even points them out as you're talking about making it quick and says, that place is safe. And they built up a lot of areas so travelers can be somewhat safe.
So I have a question for you.
Uh-huh.
If your pot sign, then does that mean the other signs used to be human?
Yes.
So yeah, glad we didn't attack sad. Any of them.
Uh-huh. Do they need to breathe?
Yes.
You're gonna dump Theo out?
With a weird question mark.
Midnight starts to look a little worried at the moment.
Step out of the house and dump out Leo.
I'll be right back.
I thought we were behind the house.
So I step a little ways away from the house and pull out the bag.
Well, Firedale said moving
10-foot sign out of the bag.
So you now have a dead sign laying next to you.
No.
It appears to be a clump of flesh as it comes out of the bag.
Oh, boy. That's not good.
Definitely took you more than 10 minutes to walk here.
I don't have a gem I can't revivify. Also, don't know if it would have been fast enough.
Don't think so.
Guys, I killed Leo.
You say this, and the other guy shakes his head and says it's okay. I'm sure he was a good sign man. You know, he takes off his invisible hat that he doesn't wear, but he does hold his hand over where his heart should be, which is kind of more on the sign part than more on his.
Colfax also pulls his hood down and just kind of bows his head and puts his little hand over his chest like he's doing the same thing.
Well, I just wanted him as a pet. I wanted a pet mimic.
This is why we ask sentient creatures for consent.
Yeah, it's not consentient for a reason.
Right.
Well, or midnight.
If there's anything in our vicinity when we go to rest, we could try the same thing to be safe. I don't know.
Throw it all in the bag.
Throw it all in the bag.
Kill it before it can get you.
Potentially kill an entire town's worth of people just because they happen to be in the wrong place.
I mean, that's fair.
Yeah, and as y'all are talking this out,
I don't like this.
You see George trying pretty badly to pull this large piece of wooden floor, like at the corner, to pull it downward as if he's trying to uncover something.
Naya will help him move it.
You help him and you're able to get an easy grip with it and help him move it on. And laying there on the ground, dug into a hole, you see several closed sacks, a few open sacks that have coinage, as far as you can tell, within the bag, and a few other various treasures. And he says, this is from other adventurers that the mimics took. Autor told me you would come through and would need it to undo all this.
Oh boy.
I like the idea of undoing all this.
I spent all my money.
And then he motions his hand and says, take it, take it.
There is quite
a lot there.
Naya will suggest that Midnight test it with the bag of gnawing first.
That's smart. I start to put them in the bag.
I'll turn to George and be like, I have a question.
Ask away.
How do we avoid getting attacked by the golems again?
Don't hit the crystals. I keep wanting to do it with the tongue, I'm sorry. So my brain still slows down to say it. Don't hit the crystals. I told you to get away because they might break through. They probably hit the crystals too much and caused the golems to activate.
Okay, so it wasn't that we hit it and were specifically targeted. It's just they got hit enough times that they activated.
If they activate, the golems go around in case anything gets out.
Gotcha. Yeah, we got attacked by one, but we managed to put the crystal back where we found it after, in the pedestal.
I'm glad you're okay. Some of this is from people that didn't.
Got it.
You cut out again.
No, I said some of this is from people that didn't.
Oh, okay.
That didn't survive the golems.
Yeah.
Yeah, you just cut off after didn't, so I wasn't sure if that was intentional.
Nope, that was intentional.
Is my bag eating the money?
You go to put it in the bag, and the bag seems perfectly fine accepting it. It does not nibble down.
Okay.
The money is good.
All right, so now I will start putting some of the money aside.
George tilts his head as he's looking at you, and he says, "No mimic there," and points at the big piece of wood. Mimic.
Hmm?
Nothing below.
The kept big safe. Wood thing was a mimic.
Oh.
Everything below kept safe.
Okay.
Okay.
Miss couldn't get through. Or should be safe.
Is a mimic tester.
Oh.
Yeah. Yes.
You do good around here.
Yeah. If it's a mimic and I put it in my bag will start nibbling on it.
So this is why I tried to bite Leo.
It doesn't like any living creature except for me to stick my hand in.
Oh. You fed to the bag?
What?
You fed him to the bag?
Well...
Is that what you tried to do to my hut?
Oh, yeah.
He shakes his head.
I stuck it on the corner of your hut to see if it...
Just to take a nibble.
He shakes his head and sighs, the big mimic half of his mouth opening way wider than, you know, the little dwarven mouth as he lets out a...
I'll cast a healing word on the hut.
You see it re-knit itself as you heal the damage that was done.
Sorry, I meant that's kind of an act first and think later.
Well, I also just didn't want to get attacked by a house.
Understandable. Understandable.
So how much gold is there?
I will give you all that after we finish.
Yeah, we'll divide it up.
Also, George, out of curiosity, have a lot of people come through here lately?
Lately, no. It has been a bit. Occasionally, a merchant does pass through with lots of guards traveling to Novell and around the lake. The center pool keeps ships from crossing over, so everything has had to go by land or air.
For
magic, and most of the teleportation circles have been disrupted somehow.
Have you seen a Harrengon lady named Daphne?
I haven't, no.
And one more really random question. I'm trying to get a hold of her. She lives in Marsand, but every time I try to reach out to her...
You mention Marsand, and he gets another little sad look on his face. And he said, Marsand has been mirrored. Most of the people there have been taken.
Been taken? And
trapped.
So can we get to Marsand?
Yeah, and he points northward. And he says, you can go back and take the other path. It'll be easier than traveling across the plains here.
Wait, ain't that where Phelan's is off to dad is?
No, in Novell. Yours is in Novell. That's east.
Why do I keep getting them mixed up?
Nana's in Marsand.
Why do I keep getting them mixed up?
Because lots of names.
Okay.
So that's
lots of cities.
That's why my sending stone is... Coming up garbled. Okay.
He nods his head enthusiastically and says, yes. They talk backwards. They hear you backwards, too.
Okay, I guess I gotta start practicing backwards.
Do you happen to know anything about a tree that gets struck by lightning too much?
There is one on the way here. It's very dark and charcoal, pretty much.
Do you know why it gets struck by so much lightning?
It's one of the trees that just kind of spread out in the plains. It's one of the few places lightning can hit, I guess.
Right. Okay.
It does get hit a lot more than the others. I have no clue why.
Got it. Got it. Do you have any special magical abilities?
He kind of looks down at his sign and up and he says, I can stand really still.
That is pretty magical. Not gonna lie. Okay, thanks.
I'm really good with bad tree puns.
Oh, please.
Wouldn't you know it?
Alright, I'm back.
Phelan's just going to groan, like, oh, so Naya. Miserable groan, like,
Naya, you gotta hear this. Do another one.
I heard that one, no.
I didn't even get a splinter of a laugh.
Yes!
Meow.
Amazing.
Phelan's just like, please make it end.
Did anyone ask about Erzahome while I was gone?
No.
Okay.
No, only the grandmother.
Right. I would like to ask if there is any reason why we would have trouble reaching people in Novale through magical messaging.
Maybe the gate? It tends to block magic pretty heavily.
Okay. So I can try again with Erzahone once we leave the hut. All right.
Yeah. So he lifts up and he says, okay, so take it and leave before things get bad tonight.
Yep.
And then he laughs.
Yep.
Then he laughs.
Put the stuff into the bag.
Thank you, George. You're great.
He grins at you with that one and kind of smiles and bows his head and says, thank you.
And I'd stake my life on that.
Hey, he laughs. Leave you here with him.
She said leave.
Yeah.
Naya's already walked out the door. She's gone.
I'm out of here.
So y'all travel away. And we will go ahead and end it there then, just stepping away from the hut with the final goodbye to George.
Can I attempt to reach out to Erzahone before we end?
You certainly can.
So as soon as we are outside of the hut, I will cast Sending again, focusing on Erzahone. And okay. I will send Erzahone, this is Naya, Phelan's here. About a day out from Novale. Are you well?
And you get a response back. He's a rather gruff, dragony, gravelly voice, I'm assuming. Is that okay, Phelan?
Yeah, he'd be old by now, so yeah.
Yeah. Sounds kind of weathered. I mean, you know, he's got that smoker's, you know, grr, in the back of his throat kind of sound. You know, he is a dragon. But anyways, really big throat. So you hear this voice that responds back and says, Phelan safe? We will be here waiting. Please come soon. Beware of mimics.
Okay. Naya can't respond back without casting another sending, so that would be the end of that conversation.
He seemed rather happy that Phelan was safe.
Naya will relay that to Phelan.
Phelan's literally going to run up on her and literally grasp her. It's like, I swear, if this is a joke...
It's not. I got an answer. He said they'll be there. He told us to beware of mimics.
I'm getting sick and tired of these mimics.
But he said they'd be there waiting.
I think the mimics are adorable.
Killed one.
That was an accident. I just wanted to have my own special mimic. Other than my bag.
And we will go ahead and end it there.
Literally, as we're ending it, Phelan's just going to look at Naya and be like, are you sure we can't leave him?
And it's not Princess, it's Midnight. That's Midnight's thoughts coming out of Princess's mouth.
Okay, she would have said her then.
Yeah. Yeah, anything that Princess is saying is... Midnight talking through Princess.
Yeah, most likely Midnight.
Naya's just acting like, okay, take this as a lesson. Creatures need to breathe. Try not to suffocate pets going forward.
Why is that something?
Poor Midnight. So anyways, thank you all for stopping by. Please remember Leo 2024 to 2024. Thank y'all for stopping by.
We'll remember you, Leo.
His name may have not have ever been Leo, but we will never know now.
Yep.
There's not enough of him left to know.
A moment of silence for unnamed sign E.
Can one of us grab Speak with Dead?
Oh, man.
Oh, no.
Probably.
That's bad. We didn't take him with us, so.
No, he's lying on the ground.
But if we ever do, and we come back through here...
B, y'all just left his dead body somewhere!
I mean, I was gonna bury him, but...
It was a clump of flesh.
Yeah, I was gonna make a hole and bury him.
I bet.
George offers to take care of it for you, because he's in a hurry for y'all to get moving. He's more concerned about your all's safety than
his own.
Burying that.
Yeah.
Okay.
So we will go ahead and end it there. Remembering Leo, and thank y'all for coming to this 22nd session of In the Demon's Grasp, where they fought a monster made out of rocks, broke a protective thing, which was one and the same, came back, met a talking sign, who was actually friendly for once, and apparently killed somebody.